Don't miss out on the special offer from my sponsor, Buy Madden Coins. They're currently giving you 20% off if you use my coupon code POODLE at checkout, and also giving you an additional 10% coins at checkout. Hey, what's up, guys? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video. And guys, today I'm going to be going over the best fantasy pack players to be choosing. By fantasy pack players, I mean the packs with the best odds and the best ones to be taking. So if you guys pre-ordered the game, obviously it comes with, I'm not entirely sure the exact number, but I think it was like 6 team fantasy packs. And if you guys don't remember, the team fantasy packs from last year were just packs that you picked a specific team and it would allow you to get a specific player from that team. Obviously it was a fantasy pack. So depending on how big the packs are, last year there were 3, I believe. You can get upwards of 1 to 3 players from that team. You can only pick one though, but it gives you 3 slots to pull something big. So obviously you want to go for the elites. Now, the chance of pulling elites last year, we're actually pretty good out of it. So I guess it's a little better than a standard pack in my opinion, because a lot of people pull the elites more so than a pro pack. Now, for this, there's 2 ways to go about this, guys. But before I get into that, if you're new, guys, Madden 20 drops tomorrow for EA Access. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Especially make sure to sub for Madden 20. The grind starts tomorrow, so guys, let's get this going. Now, for me, the best team really depends. It depends on the amount of base elites per team. So there's 2 ways to look at it. So there is obviously the base elites that have more so than others. So let's say the Patriots have the most. So when we head over to Patriots and I click filter, you see that the Patriots have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 base elites. So they most likely have the best chance of pulling an elite. But here's how this works. They have the best chance of pulling an elite, but more than likely you're going to get anywhere from David Andrews to Julian Edelman. So they won't be the best elites. Obviously they're sellable like they were last year, so you can always sell it. But this is where the dilemma comes. Would you rather get a more rare player or just an elite? So obviously there's higher risk versus higher reward packs. So like the Patriots is a low risk, medium reward, because like obviously you can get Brady, but there's more. If you see an elite flash, you're most likely getting one of these guys in this tier over here. But here's the thing. So one thing I was just talking about with some people was whether or not it's better to take a pack with less elites, so that if you see an elite flash, like, let's go over to a team like the Chiefs, right? When you look at the Chiefs, you have some higher tier guys. Now, you have Patrick Mahomes, Chris Jones, Travis Kelce, Tyreek Hill, Mitchell Schwartz. So these guys are going to be very, very expensive, especially these two up here. And this one, actually. And this one. Actually, all 4 of these guys are expensive. You're going to have, there's 3 potential banger pulls. And this one's a theme builder. I'm not entirely sure if we can even pull this out of the pack. So let's not include him for now. But there's 3 banger pulls, with Mitchell Schwartz being right there. Now, there's no 80s. But here's the thing, if you guys remember from last year, there are pack odds. So pack odds are based on overall. So like, the chance of an 80 to 81 in this pack might be 30%. The chance of an 82 to an 84 might be like 20%. The chance of an 87 pull might be only 3%. So let's say this, they had no one but Mahomes. It would seem like that might be the best pack to take, because if you've seen the leaf flash and you get Mahomes. But then again, it could also mean that it goes by those percentages, which we don't know. If it goes by those percentages, it would mean that you might not pull, you might just pull straight golds, which would make this the worst pack. It would be the highest reward pack, but it'll be the most risky, because most likely you're just gonna pull golds, because they're 3% of getting an 87, and they say there's a 97% chance of getting gold. So that's the dilemma. So the Chiefs are still obviously very good, because they do have the 81, so there's still 3, 6, 9, 11. There's still 11 total, so there's still a high chance. If you don't count Chris Jones, it's 10. But in my opinion, I'll probably be taking this pack, but that's because it's probably the riskiest pack, because you're obviously looking for one of these, and there's a good chance you're going to these. Now, like I said, if you're looking for just a safe bet of getting an elite, which you most likely, 5 times out of 10, we're going to get about 50% of the time, most people you're probably pulling elite. There's David Andrews, Michael Bennett, James Devlin, Dont'a Hightower, Joe Thuney, Jason McCourty, James White, Shaq Mason, Steven Gostkowski, Julian Edelman, Devin McCourty, and that one doesn't count probably, and Stephon Gilmore, and Tom Brady. So these are probably the safest ones, because you're going to have about, what is it, like 14 chances at getting it, with the golds probably being a little less likely out of the 3, because you get 3 chances. Now, it's seeming like the best overall option, one of the best. Before I actually get to the best, I'm going to show you my second choice, which will be the Los Angeles Rams. So let me click on filter here. The Rams have a decent amount too. So they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I might have counted that wrong, but you get the point. They have Donald, Hecker, Todd Gurley, Aqib Talib, Andrew Whitworth, Greg Zuerlein, Aqib Talib, John Johnson, again, Talib twice because it's a theme builder, Brandon Cooks, Robert Woods, Kupp, Michael Brockers, and Nickel Robey Coleman. So with these, again, there is a lot, just like the Patriots. And honestly, I think I like this one better than the Patriots because outside of Gilmore and Brady, there's not that many I really want. But anywhere from Zerlin all the way up to Donald, I would love to have on my team. So honestly, I don't really mind this one. This is probably the second best one because it's obviously high reward and less risk. But again, the issue is, like, if you've seen Elite Flash, you're most likely getting one of these. So that's, like, how you have to weigh it. Like, in my case, I might be taking the Chief just because I want to have that chance that if I see an Elite Flash, I know I'm most likely getting one of the better ones. But in this case, there's more. The 80s and 81s outweigh the better ones. But the Rams might be the best choice. Obviously, I have one more that I'm going to weigh it out with right now, which would be the Dallas Cowboys. They were also the best choice last year. They have a ton. It's okay, so for the most part, the Dallas Cowboys appear to be the best choice. It's not the highest reward, but it's the best chance of getting a high overall guy. But there's less elites in general, and there's no like 88, 89s or top guys besides Zach and Zeke. These guys are obviously good, but they're not like Mahomes or Tyreek Hill or Travis Kelce. But they're close. So like, there's multiple top guys. So in the Chiefs case, they only have four. And one of them's even an 84. And this one, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 85s. And we don't know if we can get these yet, so I'm not going to count them. But there's six. Six above 85s. And there's also an 83, 82, 82, 82, and an 80. So at worst, you get a good linebacker. And then like the rest of the worst ones are still good. Like all these guys are easily usable right in the beginning. Like the other ones, like the Patriots, are literally like 80, 80, 81, 81, 81. But these are good players too. They're not just like your typical base elites, like Amari Cooper, fast receiver, Jalen Smith, good user linebacker. Sean Lee, he's all right. I mean, stats aren't really where I like to see them. D-Law, very usable end. Leighton Vander Esch, a very usable outside linebacker. You have Frederick, going to be one of the top centers for a large majority of the game. He always is. And he's healthy this year, so we're getting a lot of upgrades. Byron Jones would be one of the top cornerbacks off the rip. Tyron Smith, one of the best, who might be the best left tackle. One of the top three, at least. And you got Chris Jones. Punter's always good to have. Obviously, like, it's not what you want. But I'll take an 85 punter over even Jalen Smith right now, so I don't mind that. And you obviously got Zeke and then Zach Martin. So, in my opinion, the Cowboys have the best overall one to take, with the Rams probably being second. And then the Patriots and the Chiefs probably at fourth. Now, while I'd be doing the Chiefs, there's a high percentage I do the Chiefs just because I'm a little riskier and I really want... I'm pretty much going all out for Pat Mahomes that first week. I want to get Pat Mahomes, get a gameplay up with him, show you guys here on the channel. So I'll probably definitely be doing the Chiefs pack, a few of them at least. I want Mahomes, I want Kelce, I want Hill. I love all these players in Madden, so definitely be going all in on them, especially Hill and Mahomes. But for the most part, guys, so the highest reward one is probably going to be, in my opinion, the highest reward. Like, the best possible is going to be the Chiefs and the Rams. But the safest ones... The safest one's probably the Dallas Cowboys. The overall best with reward and safeness, probably the Cowboys. The second best, probably Rams. Third best for me would be the Chiefs, and the fourth would be the Patriots. Patriots are safer than the Chiefs, but I don't like any of those Patriot players. Even if I pull Brady, I won't use them. Probably sell them. I mean, I'm probably using them for the first week or two. And then another one that's, like, pretty good, that's just up there in the same range as, like, the Chiefs is... This one, only because they only have literally six players. So this one, you know, this one's good if they do another Team Diamond pack like last year. If you guys remember, the Team Diamond pack from last year guaranteed you five elites from a certain team. So in this case, there's only six. So the chances that you have to get at least Hopkins or Watt no matter what. So I remember last year, Texans were the best one last year for lack of elites. So yeah, you'd get him, and him. But then you're guaranteed at least two out of these three. No matter what, you can even pull all three of these and just not get one of these guys. So if they have a pack like that, oh, this one's a team builder. So if they do five, you're guaranteed all of these guys. So this one will be the, if you want to go all out, best reward, probably doing the Texans. In the case of just that you can get Hopkins, Watt, or Clowney, all going to be very, very overpriced guys early in the game. And if they do a diamond pack like last year, it will definitely be very usable. So if I was you guys, I'd probably do, like I said, I already said my order. But the Texans are up there, but for this one, not so much. I don't think I'd use my pack on this. But if there is a diamond pack of last year, the Texans and the Cowboys will be definitely up there again. All right, guys, so that's about it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed. Hope this helps you guys day one of Madden. I will be most likely revisiting this after the first week, after I see what... Not revisiting this, but I will be revisiting a lot of these videos I'm making, such as the best pre-order. I'm going to be doing a best pre-order elites to take two, and then I'll obviously revisit that right off the rip tomorrow off EA Access for people who haven't gotten the game yet. So that I can see the players, see what their stats are, see everything, get a feel for them, get a feel for the game, and then I'll reevaluate what I think are the best for those, and I'll make that video maybe tomorrow when I get the game. pending. I should be having, like, if the game comes out tomorrow when it should, I should have, like, 4 or 5 videos up tomorrow. It comes out at midnight. I'll be grinding all night, up all night, playing it. So, hopefully. So, guys, if you're still here, make sure to drop a like. Make sure to drop a like, comment, and subscribe. Madden 20 starts in approximately 24 hours, hopefully. So, you won't want to miss that, guys. I'm out. See you guys in the next video.